What is that one piece of knowledge you'd like to impart in your sales team as well as your managerial team in order to take their sales speech output or sales performance to the next level, or the team cohesiveness, the interpersonal relationship to the next level? What is that one piece of information, one piece of knowledge you'd like to impart in your team? Hello friends, this is RC here, and today I'm going to share with you an interesting theory which is called as 4 P's of personalities, 4 P's of performance. I'm sure this particular information or knowledge would definitely help everybody, not only sales professionals, not only managers, even interpersonal relationship among family people, family members, business, everybody who is dealing with people, who is interacting with people, this is going to help them, all of them. So, to start with, I would like to give a bit of background, as I always do. Friends, I remember early days of my professional career as a sales representative, when I was very new in my territory and I was given a list of clients, list of customers. And my boss told me, go to these customers and this is what your daily plan is. What happened? On the third day, he gave me a call very early morning and said, today you are going to meet this client, which is a very important and very egoistic client. Be cautious while you meet them. And frankly speaking, friends, egoistic and important client, and deal carefully. That is what my boss told me. And I was like wondering, important hai, egoistic way hai, how to go about it? Say it becomes tedious. Means say, how would a new sales individual who had just walked out of college and started going to the field, doing sales speech, sales promotion, based on the training or product training received by the company, how would that individual deal with the client? I'll tell you what happened. Sorry. I approached that client with lots of caution and lots of fear in my mind. I had that fear that I should not do something because of which I might lose that client. So, the important client should have been approached assertively, but I approached defensively. Actually, important or productive client, I should have walked in confidently and happily, but I walked in with caution and defensive mindset. And it continued for quite some time till I figured out some of the personality traits on my own and then started approaching different clients differently, as most of you do. But when I became 10 years down the line, when I became senior regional manager, that question or that experience still kept on haunting me. I was always wondering, can there be a better way of training new sales representatives how to go over the clients? I did my research and I came up with this 4P theory. Of course, the lots of information is available on Google, YouTube, everywhere. And as always, I came up with the theory means I have researched, I have read about it, and I am bringing that consolidated information to you. So friends, it's never good to send people to important clients or any client, because I firmly believe any client who is in your list is an important client. Any individual who is in your life is an important individual for you. So whether it's personal level relationship or whether it's sales relationship or whether it's hierarchy based, team based, management, manager's role and team management, interpersonal relationship, the personalities matter, because every individual has a pattern of behavior, and that behavior comes from the personality that individual is having. And when I researched, I found that grossly, there are 4 prominent personalities available. There could be some fractions and the subparts of it, but grossly, if you look into, there are 4 types of personalities. And I'm going to share with you some of the traits of these personalities. Okay, I'm sure if instead of approaching client in the same way or blindly or based on guesswork, individual guess is different, so individual approach would be different. If we put this into a scientific way, scientific method is used, this is going to definitely help us, all the new sales representatives, new managers, to deal with people better. This would have better relationship outcome, better business outcome. Everything would go to the next level. That is what I expect. And I suggest all of you, because this was a suggestion from one of my friends. For his team, I took a 2.5 hour workshop and I taught them what kind of personalities are there and how these personalities, understanding of these personalities, can help you improve your sales pitch output, improve your interpersonal relationship output. So he requested me to make this video, and that's why I'm here. He has deliberately told me not to share his name. Otherwise, I like to take names of people who have given me ideas or who have contributed to my life. So the four P's which I'm going to, and I would urge you to do more research on that, so that you have in-depth knowledge of it. So to start with four P's, first P is the people who are power seeker. Okay, many a times egoistic becomes a vague term, but when I'm talking about power seeker, this is a part of personality. So what are the characteristics of power seeker people? These are the people who want to be in charge. These are the people who want to be direct. These are the people who are blunt. These are the people who seek power, who seek authority. These are the people who are rigid. These are the people who do not give a second thought while taking a harsh decision. These are the people who would be like spontaneous and rigid. So that combination makes them very deadly. Okay, so these are like bossy people, and we need to find ways of dealing with them. So if you know a person is of this time, this type, who is rigid, who is bossy, who is not flexible, who wants authority, then you can plan your way in. The another P of people management or understanding people is process oriented. These are the people highly focused on processes. So these are the people who would like to have authentic data. These are the people who would want anybody visiting them to be punctual. These are the people who are like perfectionist. These are the people, they would like to know what and how of everything before accepting your sales proposal. These are the people who are slow to react. These are the people who are investigative. So when you know an individual is classified into a process-oriented personality, you can approach them based on these parameters. You can give them authentic information. You can be punctual. You can follow the procedure. You can give them answers of what and how. Another personality, okay, the third P of the personality is people who are praise seekers. So I said power seeker, then I said process oriented. Now people who are praise seeker, this is the third personality. These are highly flexible people. These are very talkative people. These are people who are very friendly. These are the people who are defensive at times if you try to take them out of their comfort zone. These are the people who lack time management, so you would end up spending much more time with them. These are the people who like to take limited risk. So when you are approaching people who are praise seeker, you can have your this thing. And as I told you, there is huge data available on net. You can search that, because when you know to whom you are approaching, you can have a plan, person specific plan. Definitely that plan would give you rich dividend, rich outcome. Then moving to the next personality type, these are peace seekers. So peace seekers are like what? They are flexible. Praise seeker are highly flexible. Peace seeker are flexible. These are people who are people oriented, and they would like to have win-win situation. They would not like to disturb your harmony. They would not like you to invade in their comfort zone. Additionally, these are the people who are cooperative, who are very patient, supportive, and These are the people who need security, who need assurance, who need someone to understand them and give them that belief of being there. So these are the people who are peace seekers. So when I know what kind of personality and how to approach them, then automatically, right from the way I enter into the next person's whatever the office or home or whatever area, or whenever I am giving them a call, or whenever I am saying a hello to them, whenever I am approaching them, whenever I am putting a sales pitch, or whether it's your family member whose personality is known to you, so you can deal with them in that specific way, I am sure this is going to yield hugely positive output to each and every sales pitch, because now your sales pitch or relationship talk or your talk to the teammate would be person specific, what we call as his tailor made kind of pitch you can have. Just imagine a power seeker subordinate and you are talking to him and you are like senior boss. Still, that personality has to be taken into consideration. Just imagine someone is in a position of higher authority and he is a peace seeker, win-win situation. Then you will have to plan it different way. Imagine someone who is process oriented, you will have to plan it different way. Imagine someone who is a praise seeker, you will have to plan it different way. Basically, this is a tailor-made person, interpersonal relationship or self-speech approach, and I am sure this will help you. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel, share with your friends, tag your friends, like, press like button, share button, and let me know if you would like to know more about any of the topics so that I can make video. And as far as how to deal with these people are concerned, I'm going to make one video each dealing with different kind of personality. I'm sure friends you have liked this. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.